नमस्ते नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, वन एंड ऑल। द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ इट, सी बेसिकली वी हैव साइंस, कॉमर्स एंड ह्यूमैनिटीज। The present day education system, if we really see or if we really look at, it is more or less based on the systematic study of the understanding about the subject as a single entity. Let's say I am a commerce graduate and I am trying to, I do have the computer skills and I wanted to learn the computer part of it. However, since I have taken commerce, I would not be able to get into that. However, the new educational policy is talking about the diversified part of it. Anyone can take any course and work on it. The point is, let's say like he or she works on the computer part, artificial intelligence or decoding or coding, etc., etc. What if company has a standard guidelines telling that only BE BTechs can apply for this, having that background and who is having knowledge? Because in today's generation, there are very few companies like Google. Not every company is a Google, right? How is the new educational policy going to address that? To share an experience with you, when I was trying to apply for digital marketing as an intern for a software company, they asked me, "Do you have knowledge about the software? Are you a BE or BTech? Do you have 4 years of education?" Now, this is the scenario where he or she will be really petrified when he or she gets to a job. How is the government going to address this? What if a human, a BTech graduate getting into the commerce part? Yes, definitely he can get into that because they do have that in their project management level. And they are touching upon all the primary aspects of the subject. My question to the people or to the authorities is, how far are we addressing this question? If he or she is having that knowledge and he or she is having applying that, in his or her day-to-day life, as a religious practice, will he or she be able to establish himself or herself when the situation like this comes? Let's be honest and let's be very straight on this point. Are we really generous enough to accept the fact that a non-commerce guy, a non-engineering graduate without experience, if given an opportunity, would he or she be able to able to handle in case that training is being given? Are the companies ready to do that with the existing SLAs or knowledge level, existing knowledge processes? Because not everyone are Google's company like Google. How is the new educational policy introduced by the government going to address this issue? Is a very primary point which I wanted to really ask, and still it's a question mark. And what is the growth potential when it comes to promotions? Can we really look at it? It still remains an open-ended question. However, digital marketing, fine. Digital marketing is always prevailing and it prevails. But what is the use of teaching a coding language to the one who is not interested, or to the one when it is taught, when it is of no use, when a company asks if you are a BA or BTech only, then apply? It doesn't really make any sense. How are we addressing this issue? Like this, there are many other courses. Let's try understanding this. Is there a way wherein we could really look at it? This still remains an open-ended question. New educational policy has been rolled out, signed out. But what are the steps that government are taking to resolve this issue, which is deep-rooted? They need to remove it from the grassroots level. Do we have that kind of infrastructure where we can educate people? Because we still find that narrow-mindedness in the middle class families. Who is going to address this? Is there someone, or is the government coming up with an action plan? This is one of the greatest pitfall which one can realize. Think about it. It still remains as an open-ended question. The pointers from this video being is the new educational policy thinking of how exactly the implementation and the practical application part goes about? Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day ahead.